The Caribbean Mentorship Institute has designated the month of July as Anti-Bullying Month for youths across St. Lucia. Officials say bullying is a very serious concern for many schools, parents and students. This concern stems primarily from the devastating impact that it has on students and their learning environments. As a result, the Institute has designed various community awareness programs which will help sensitize students to the nature, effects and solutions to curb the levels of bullying within their schools, communities and peer groups. According to the CMI, cyberbullying is one of the latest trends where the pictures of victims get splashed across the net, accompanied by negative remarks. The CMI and others are currently exploring solutions to curb this social ill, which they say is designed to, among other things, sully the reputation of the victims.
It's really about a stronger person or a group of stronger individuals taking advantage of someone who is much weaker than they are.
Okay, so that would include verbal insults, threats, things like that?
Verbal insults, threats, name calling, cyberbullying, social isolation in terms of causing young persons to be excluded from the group, excluded from the whole world of play. All of those things fall on the bullying. It's indirect bullying, as you've mentioned, in terms of the hitting, the shoving, the pushing, and then the indirect bullying in terms of having some person, for example, do the bullying for you. You have situations, for sure in Barbados, where the bully stays at home and he has some person else do the bullying for him. And so that by the time that person gets into trouble, the bully is absolutely clear of any kind of incident.
The trainers also wanted to make it abundantly clear that bullying is not confined to physical confrontations. They say it also includes verbal insults or threats and is designed to humiliate the victims and isolate them from their peers. The trainers noted that in some cases, the bully seeks to hide his identity by getting others to do his dirty work as he attempts to run from the consequences of his actions. Authorities cite this as one of the main reasons why the program seeks to target as wide an audience as it can. To achieve this, the program is equipped with a train-the-trainers component that will prepare students to pass on their knowledge to their peers.
So what we're trying to do is not only to alleviate some of the problems on the internet, we're trying to alleviate the problems as of now. Not only alleviate it, but try to manage it and make them aware that these things hurt people and these things hurt their peers. And we do not want to get in a situation where it gets out of hand, where violence of self or the other individual comes into play. And we've been recognizing that. I mean, based in St. Lucia, what we've been seeing, based in Barbados, Trinidad, Grenada, all the other islands, we are experiencing where the youth are becoming a lot more agitated very easily. They do not know how to handle the problems. And I think as citizens and elders in the society, we have to start guiding our young persons. And again, that's what mentoring is about, is to provide that kind of guidance. And so when we were told about the training, we felt it was a good opportunity to come and train them on that area so that they would be prepared at least for the next academic year.
The anti-bullying program will last for 1 week and will be conducted at schools across the island. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.